The WWF, what the world is watching.
Welcome, everyone, to the World Wrestling Federation Spotlight. I'm Vince McMahon, and joining me, as always, Lord Alfred Hayes. This week, we'll see the Bushwhackers in tag team action. Also, to join us will be the Rockers. They are indeed tag team specialists. And then from there, the Powers of Pain. We have three tag team matches on hand for you this week. However, perhaps the most important thing will be the Brother Love Show, I'm sorry to say, important only because of whom he has as his guest. The Mega Powers. We're talking about Hulk Hogan and the Macho Man Randy Savage, and they are looking for action this Friday night.
They certainly are, and they'll get all the action they can deal with, of course, with you-know-who.
I think I do. The Twin Towers you're making reference to.
I am, and I didn't have to say that because Akeem and Big Boss Man, they can speak for themselves, they can act for themselves, and they can do everything for themselves.
Well, on this Friday night, on national television, they meet the Mega Powers. Who's going to win, Alfred?
I'm going to have to go with Bossman. After all, he gave Hulk Hogan a lesson before, and Akeem is no pushover at all.
We'll have a further word on that, but right now, let's get right into action.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team match is scheduled for one fall. In the ring to my left, at a total combined weight of 503 pounds, from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, Tom Stone. His partner from Raleigh, North Carolina, Jerry Price.
Thus far undefeated here in the World Wrestling Federation. All right, is that Luke or Butch in the ring now?
That's Butch in the ring. You know how I can tell them apart, McMahon?
I have the vaguest idea.
Luke's the one with no teeth.
Luke is the one with no teeth.
That's right.
If they're not smiling, how can you tell them apart? We spoke to them earlier on. You be the judge.
Glory! Isn't this great, cousin Luke?
Bloody great,
mate. Reminds me of the fights in the pub. The fights in the sherry shed. The rougher, the bloody tougher. The more we like, cousin. We like beating up, cousin Luke. And we're going to keep on doing it. We're going to work in style.
Yay!
All right, on our left, then, that was Luke, right?
Luke's the one without the teeth. Butch is the one that does most of the talking.
I see. You always were perceptive, Jesse.
Definitely. That's my job, McMahon.
I see.
I'm the best color man in the business.
Really? I thought maybe John Madden. And to the buckle there, the tag is finally made. New man in the ring, and Butch. Ooh, wow, what a clothesline that was.
And that was a vicious clothesline. And I'll say this about the Bushwhackers. They're pretty good at tag team wrestling if you watch them. They're brawlers, they're roughhousers, but they know the concept of tag team wrestling. Quick tags, keep the man in your corner, and moves like that, you're going to win matches.
And it's Luke now with a forearm down across the chest area.
Jerry Price is not faring too well out there, is he?
I wouldn't say so. Tag was made in the Butch. Ooh, with a kick. Perpetual motion, these Bushwhackers. They're always moving. Back body drop nicely done.
Little Lestrian history, a lesson in history, McMahon.
How so?
New Zealand, that used to be a prison colony of England, didn't it?
Matter of fact, I think you're correct there. Jeff.
I can believe that after watching these two guys. They look like they ought to be in jail.
I wouldn't say that.
I'm told they're a bunch of lovable guys outside the ring.
Yeah, with only a face a mom could love.
Well, maybe. What is that? Ooh. What was that, Jesse?
That's a different style of a battering ram, I guess you'd call it. Or I guess you could say he was using his head, right, McMahon?
In a matter of speaking, yeah.
These two might be thinking man's wrestlers after watching that.
Tag made again. And a double team effort. Ooh, ah. Knees to the rib area. And that could be it. So Butch and Luke. Like to bring those home for dinner. Ooh, they scared each other, Jess.
I can believe that. Here you see that battering ram, Butch, with Luke's head. Boom. Head first in, and there's like a, you can't call it a backbreaker, I guess a double stomach breaker. Look at those two pretty faces.
Standing by, so we are told, is none other than Brother Love. Said with all sincerity.
Hey, no!
Together, there's a real long history between the Mega Powers and the Twin Towers. First off, the Big Boss Man, the Hulkster himself right here. I was the first one to feel the lick of the stick, man. I know what the Big Boss Man's all about. And the Macho Man, Randy Savage, he knows what the stick's all about, too, don't you, brother?
The pain, yes, I am. And I'm going to tell you something else. Hulk Hogan, a king, is a man that thinks he's got a lot of soul. But what he's got is 457 pounds. You felt the damage, and I felt the damage that he can do. Brother Love, you're right about one thing. This Friday night is going to be the greatest tag team match of all time, yeah.
You see, the only love that I feel at this time is the love generated by Brother Love. You see, because there just doesn't seem to be the affection. connection that once existed between the mega powers, which makes me wonder just how powerful are the mega powers.
Well, first thing, brother love, all these Hulkamaniacs and the Macho Man and the lovely Elizabeth, we know what kind of love you know all about. That's the love of money, brother love, and the love you've got for your benefactors, and that's not going to take you to the bank. The type of love here that we're experiencing that you know nothing about is the mega power triangle of love, brother. All you got to do is take one look at the Macho Man when he stares at Elizabeth, when she stares at him, when their eyes meet. The power of love is so strong between those two, I'm surprised they just don't melt in their tracks. That's the love between a man and a woman. But you know something, brother love? I love Elizabeth just as much as the Macho Man does, but in a different way. I love Elizabeth like a sister, like blood, like a 10 twin towers trying to hurt her. I fight to the last dying breath. But also, brother love, there's another love that you don't understand about. That's the love I have for the Macho Man. It's just as strong as Elizabeth. I love him like a brother. And if any one of the twin towers or anybody was ever trying to hurt Macho Man, just like we proved in the past, we'll stand there and fight till our last dying breath.
Ooh, yeah! Brother love, you want to know how powerful the mega powers are? Oh, yeah. Everybody knows that the twin towers are big, strong, high buildings, yeah. Larger than any buildings in New York City. These guys are big and bad. I'm telling you something right now. They may be earthquake-proof. They may be typhoon-proof. They may be tidal wave-proof. But when the mega powers, the strongest force in the universe, goes against the twin towers, it's gonna be like a fault line going right through their foundation. And the Richter scale is gonna spin around 42 times, go into orbit, and you're gonna see the twin towers come crumbling down, yeah.
Well, you know, brothers and sisters, reading back through time, there was one character, well, one woman to be exact. I believe her name was Jezebel. And you know, she always seemed to be at the root of all evil. You see, it always seems at the root of all evil, there stands a woman. Which brings me to wonder, will your manager, Miss Elizabeth, maybe be more of a hurt than a help?
You know, brother love, you're borderline, man. But right now, I'm going to explain to you that there's going to be a whole lot of help and there's going to be a whole lot of hurt in this match. As far as the mega power goes, Elizabeth is our foundation, man. She's taught us how to tear the Twin Towers down one block at a time. And if something happens, we could wipe out the whole foundation and destroy them all at once. But you know, on the other hand, brother love, there's going to be a whole lot of hurt also. Because Macho Man, you remember a few weeks ago when the Boss Man grabbed Elizabeth's wrist, man, when he tried to drag her over to Akeem, who was foaming at the mouth. You saw the hurt on her face. All that hurt on her face, we're to return to the Twin Towers. And all I've got to say, brother, when the smoke clears, it's going to be the towers or the powers standing. And what are they going to do when the mega powers and the lovely Elizabeth comes running through, brother?
All right, so there we have it. The Macho Man Randy Savage and Hulk Hogan, the mega powers. And they are unquestionably together all the way. We'll find out which is the more powerful force, the mega powers or the twin towers this
time. Introducing first in the ring area from Mile West, Puerto Rico, weighing in at 235 pounds, here is Jose Luis Rivera.
Jose Luis Rivera taking on a very tough youngster here this week at Wrestling Challenge in the form of Mr. Purple.
River, Minnesota.
You know, if the guys like the Red Rooster think they can make a fool out of me on my own television program, they're badly mistaken.
Yeah, you're right, because you could do that all by yourself. You don't need any help.
Let's talk about Mr. Perfect. Red Rooster is yesterday's garbage.
I haven't scored a setting yet with that piece of garbage from Brooklyn.
The Brooklyn Brawler. That's between you and him. I had nothing to do with that.
Okay.
You know better than that. You know I'd never get involved in an altercation with you.
Look out. Nice shoulder block by Jose Luis. Oh, right up over the top. He looks like Mr. Perfect right here. Coming into the World Wrestling Federation with some very impressive credentials. Referring to Mr. Perfect.
What an athlete this man is.
Says he can do it all. Well, I expected him to say that. Nice drop kick. Oh. He did that perfectly. Went right through the ropes perfectly.
That's not funny.
Came this right man down on his head.
This man prides himself on being perfect.
Well, he wasn't too perfect there, was he?
Funny thing is, he doesn't have to work at it. It just comes natural. He's perfect.
Better polish himself up.
Yeah. You watch. He's perfect. He'll show you.
Yeah, he tells you, too. Earlier on, we had a chance to talk to him, and it was less than a perfect interview, I might add.
You're kidding. Here he is. He's perfect.
I'm going to ask you people to do me a favor. As hard as it may seem, take your eyes off of me. Find yourself a mirror. Look into it. What do you see? Nothing perfect.
What does he think he sees when he looks in the mirror?
Well, he sees
what do
something.
You see when you look in the mirror?
I see a very intelligent man.
Yeah, I would check the want ads, too, if I were you. You'd take a look at the newspaper.
For what? Well.
Very painful move right here. Great by both legs.
Now you take a look at who Mr. Perfect is.
Ooh. Adding insult to injury.
Nothing like slapping a guy.
Yeah. Well, you want to start again?
Not with me. Don't. I'm wearing glasses.
Yeah. Really, he didn't have to turn that loose. I think he could have got a submission with that.
No, he's not satisfied yet. He wants to show you all his perfect moves.
Well, he didn't look too perfect earlier on in this matchup.
Rivera's a tough man.
He'll find some perfect opponents here in the World Wrestling Federation. All the top guns are here. He won't have any trouble finding any good competition. Reverse the lookout. High cross body. Nobody hauled perfect. Got out of the way.
Well, Rivera, that's using your head, you dummy.
Could be the beginning of the end right here.
There we go.
Oh, look at this.
Perfect, Plex. I bet you.
Cradle suplex. It's all over, folks.
Nobody does it like him.
Well, here's Mike McGurk.
Here is your winner, Mr. Perfect, Kurt Hennig.
Well, I hope we can see more of that.
Take a look.
Good
news.
Didn't
even mess his hair up.
Well, look at this. Now, Rivera's. Drop kick there. Lucky though. Lucky though.
Oh,
but now he regrouped.
Too happy about that. It looked too perfect there.
Not perfect, Plex. Look at the arch of the back. One, two, three.
Latest edition of World Wrestling Federation magazine on the stands right now. On the cover, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, and inside a most interesting article on the lovely manager Elizabeth at home on the range. Right now, let's go to the World Wrestling Federation Event Center.
It will take place right here in Baltimore, Friday evening, March 3rd, at the Baltimore Arena. Mark that date down. You will not want to miss this spectacular evening of live WWF action headed your way. That night, the Mighty Hercules, he will take on Mr. Perfect Kurt Hennig. The Bushwhackers in tag team competition, they will meet the fabulous Rougeau brothers. Also, Tito Santana, he will take on the King of the World Wrestling Federation, King Haku. Also, listen to this tag team encounter. Andre the Giant, he will team with Ravishing Rick Rude. They will face the team of the Ultimate Warrior and Jake the Snake Roberts. And can you believe there is more? The Honky Tonk Man, he will face Bret the Hitman Hart. And revenge is the topic of conversation in this encounter. Bret Hart is standing by.
You know, I've been telling myself for so long that I just gotta stay cool. I just gotta stay real cool and real calm. It bothered me. Sure, it bothered me, the 25% that Jimmy Hart was taking. Yeah, that bugged me a lot. It bugged me, the Rougeaus bugged me a lot, too. But now I am not cool, I am hot. Because Honky Tonk Man, you went too far this time when you busted that guitar over my head. Now it's payback time.
Bret the Hitman Hart, he's got a big score to settle with a honky-tonk man. A spectacular tag team encounter. Jake the Snake Roberts, the team with the Ultimate Warrior. They'll meet ravishing Rick Rude and Andre the Giant.
You know, Jake Roberts, you're an out-and-out fool. You should learn not to mess with the Giant. And as for the Ultimate Warrior, it's going to take all the strength you can muster and all the courage you have in your body just to step in the ring with us, too.
And that's all it's going to be.
But, Jake, if you want some more punishment, you should ask her the nice way. I couldn't give you some more because I got some rest. Oh, Jake, it's my pleasure to get back in the ring with you guys. And you, Ultimate Warrior, you think you're the top of the world because you own the Intercontinental belt? I give you some news. You're going to see who's on top of the world.
What a tag team encounter it will be. Friday night, March 3rd at the Baltimore Arena. Right now, feel the power of the WWF.
Nintendo Entertainment System presents the Fabulous Russo Brothers. The self-proclaimed All-American boys here combine their power to destroy another opponent. Jacques and Raymond Rougeau, proof that in America, anything is possible. Clamps down hard. Headbutt. And goes for the cover.
That headbutt to the solar plexus there. Sean was quite a move. But look at Garvin. He's not really perplexed by any of this.
Off the ropes right into a bear hug by Dino Bravo. And Garvin way up high. Feet off the ground. Now they just touch. Dino Bravo really has that bear hug set. And you can see those massive arms.
You can also see Frenchie smiling away there. Obviously very confident that his man is going to bring out a victory here.
And we'll see which man can last longer in this one. And Alfred, you've mentioned many times that in a bear hug, the man actually implementing the bear hug takes a great deal of strength out of him as well.
It certainly does. And you know, when I was talking to you before, when that reverse...
Interference there by Frenchie Martin. And rugged Ronnie Garvin did not like that one bit.
Now this is a dangerous situation here for Garvin, because he's got to keep his eyes not only on him, but on him too.
A knee right to the back of Garvin as he turned his back on Dino Bravo. In an attempt to run rugged Ronnie Garvin into the ring post, Garvin pulled up short, and it's Bravo who went into the post. And we've got the bell, Alfred.
Yes, I'm not quite sure what that is.
Both men were counted out?
Yes, or it could be a disqualification there. There was interference in the beginning by Frenchie Martin. And look, he's caught Frenchie. Garvin's got him, and Dino is outside the ring, so there's nobody to protect Frenchie right now.
And here comes his protector, and Garvin saw it coming and nailed him with a big right.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is the referee's official decision. He has ruled this contest a double count out.
We are back at the World Wrestling Federation Event Center. Action taking place here in Baltimore. Friday evening, March 3rd, at the Baltimore Arena. In one encounter, Bret the Hitman Hart to face the Honky Tonk Man. And if you'll recall, a tag team encounter that took place involving these two men. Bret the Hitman Hart, the victim of a tuning up by the Honky Tonk Man and his guitar. And revenge will be on the mind of Bret the Hitman Hart Friday evening, March 3rd. Right now, the Honky Tonk Man, his opponent, is standing by, along with his manager, Jimmy Hart.
Look, Bret Hart, look what happened to you when you tried to put your filthy hands on Jimmy Hart, the Mouth of the South. You're not going to do it anymore, are you? Oh, listen to that song, Bret Hart. Listen to that song. I love that song. I love it. Yeah, Bret Hart, you try to put your hands on Jimmy again, uh-huh. You try to mess with Jimmy Hart. Turn your back on the honky-tonk man. Oh, yeah. You felt something, didn't you, Bret Hart? You greaseball. All that grease and that slick back hair. I don't like it, Bret Hart. I don't like any part of it.
Jimmy Hart, or as he is referred to as the Colonel by the Honky Tonk Man, As he advises the honky-tonk man in this encounter, he had better be ready. Bret the Hitman Hart is fired up. The Fabulous Rougeau Brothers in tag team action. They will face the Bushwhackers, Luke and Butch from New Zealand.
Whoa! Yay! I hear we've got the Rougeau's cousin and that little slimy manager, the Mouth of the South.
Yeah, I hear that too, Cousin Luke. And you know, they come from overseas somewhere. And I hear now they claim to the people in the U.S., bloody A, that they're now living in Memphis, Cousin Luke.
Memphis, Cousin
Luke? Yeah, Memphis, Cousin Luke.
And that Jimmy Hart runs around with a megaphone, mate.
And I'm sure that Jimmy Hart, if you think you're going to get involved with the Bushwhackers with that megaphone, you've got another.
He's a bloody thing, Marilyn. He's a bloody
guy. Beat the people of the USA and be so good to the Bushwhackers. We're going to be good to the people of the USA. Okay. Take care of the Rougeaus. And here we are.
Now, the Bushwhackers, you have gotten an up close and personal look, but wait until you see them live. Luke and Butch. From New Zealand, you've seen them in the lingerie store. You've even seen them eat lunch. Not exactly the pair you would invite home to dinner, but Friday night, March 3rd at the Baltimore Arena, they'll be here to meet the Fabulous Rougeau Brothers.
Ravishing!
Bobby the Brain Heenan leading Ravishing Rick Rude to the ring.
Well, I don't know. There's...
Yeah, she don't make it.
No, all right.
Too young.
Nice t-shirt. Oh, come on. Look at this guy. I really don't know what the women see in him.
You don't?
No.
Well,
there
you
go. Yes, yes.
Yeah.
There.
You on the right?
This man is so arrogant.
What I'd like to have right now is for all you fat, ugly, Huntsville
nice
heifers.
Keep
the noise down.
Uh-oh.
While I take my robe off and show the ladies the sexiest man on God's green earth. Hit the music.
Look at, cameras are ready, McMahon.
Yep.
Now, in just a second, you'll see why. There. That's what they see in him.
Well, compare his physique with that of the Ultimate Warriors is like horse manure and ice cream.
I disagree with you.
Oh, really? We're
yeah.
going to hear from the Ultimate Warrior in just a moment in a pre-recorded comment.
The superposed gun was yours, Hell and Ravishing. Now you must step into the darkness and the cold, cold world of the Ultimate Warrior. Don't walk with your head too high because the Power Warriors will knock it right off and eat you alive.
You understand that?
Not too much of it, but I think he's upset with Ravishing Rick Rude. I can get that much out of it.
You've got that right. Well, that stunt Rude pulled last Sunday.
Well, you know, you got to remember something, you know. The World Wrestling Federation left the judging up to the fans, McMahon.
Yeah.
In Houston,
as
Texas.
It should be.
As it should be.
That's the way I view
it. How many
it?
Of them fans are qualified to know a bicep from a tricep? Not too many of them.
All right, I'll grant you that.
Yeah, so you're going to make them the judge, and you got to remember something else. In any physique contest, the judgment is strictly opinion.
Uh-huh.
You could take the same contestants, change the judges the next day, and have a totally different result.
Well, there's a result right there, the Rude Awakening, that's for sure. As far as...
I think, personally, the Warriors are a sore loser.
Oh, my goodness. You saw what Ravishing Rick Rude did to the Warriors.
That's
digging
right.
up behind him and laying him open, knocking him unconscious temporarily. The Warriors never been...
Wait, hold it, hold it, hold it. It's time for the Rude Awakening.
Are you ready to give some lucky lady the Rude Awakening?
Oh, that's the one? Oh, my God.
No way, Bobby, not here. You know, I'm glad you said that, because as I looked around here and I searched, there's nothing worthwhile.
What a matchup. I believe this could very well be one of the greatest tag team matchups of all time coming your way this Friday night at 8 p.m. Eastern Time when the Mega Powers, Hulk Hogan and the Macho Man Randy Savage meet the Twin Towers. You saw the Brother Love interview. The Mega Powers, I think, have convinced me at least there is no friction. If there is, I don't believe it'll be a factor at all in their tag team matchup this Friday.
No, absolutely no factor. I believe I said that some time ago. I don't think their professional pride would let them allow personal feelings to creep in at all. They are together as I have never seen them together.
All right, let's talk about the Twin Towers. How together are they?
Well, there again is another situation because Slick has brought those two together like you cannot believe. The Big Boss Man, we know what he can do to Hulk Hogan already. Akeem is a devastating wrestler. Together, the Twin Towers are a terrible, terrible threat.
That's going to be some match this Friday.
From the pages of the World Wrestling Federation magazine, here's update.
All right, hi again, everybody. Bobby the Brain Heenan considers himself the consummate manager in all of professional sports. He has molded and developed some of the most awesome talent in the World Wrestling Federation today. Names like Andre the Giant, the Brain Busters, Ravishing Rick Rude, and as of a couple of weeks back, even the Red Rooster. However, things do change, as we see here from Saturday night's main event. Let's go to the footage.
And Heenan is a better.
What are you doing? What are you doing? And things like that.
Then this past week, millions saw an incident occur where Bobby Heenan and the Red Rooster were going to end a business relationship the way two gentlemen should, on a handshake.
Like I'm through with you, you're through with me.
Yes.
I made a mistake.
Sounds good to me.
Forget it.
Forget it.
Forget it.
Not very often. He apologizes.
Okay.
Forget it.
Okay.
Oh, what? Why are you doing that?
Doing nothing.
Why would you do that?
Come on, Marty. Get him. Get him. Choke him. Choke him.
Hey. 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 Pull him out there. Choke him. Choke him. Choke him.
The Red Rooster is out after that incident, and Bobby Heenan has dramatically introduced Steve Lombardi as the Brooklyn Brawler. And folks, I gotta tell you, it ain't over yet. No, by no stretch of the imagination. For update, I'm Gene Oakham.
WrestleMania 5!
Ticket information, call toll free, 1-800-233-4050.
There's an interesting combo right there.
The Rockers?
No, these guys are tag team specialists.
That's what I hear.
I can't wait until they meet the Brain Busters. What a match that's going to be. We had one, almost had one, several weeks ago here on Wrestling Challenge. Remember that, Brain, when you guys chickened out?
Chickened out. They caused it. They started it.
If you stop.
I'll tell you something. It'll take a good team to beat the Brain Busters. And it'll take a good team to beat the Rockers, but it won't take us long.
Yeah.
You know, I got something coming up. I always want you to sit there and be quiet. Because you're going to learn
a little
something.
Are you going to take over?
I'm going to handle everything.
Oh.
And you just watch this. Because I got my brainbusters lined up in the other control room.
There's tag team combination right there. All right, I'll keep quiet. I won't say a word.
Keep an eye on the Rockers, Tully.
Yes, Bobby. You know nothing is going to escape us.
All right, I want these guys put out of commission.
Yes, Bob, we can absolutely guarantee you a Wall Street top crash for the Rockers. Bell runs over, courtesy of the Brainbuster.
Now, you tell me I don't have my team ready.
Well, you got to do it inside the ring, Brain. You can't do it behind the microphone.
But we're watching at all times. We're watching every move these two punks put out.
What's the matter? You're too cheap to spend some money and put these guys on tape and take a real good look at them? No, you got to have your guys sneaking, looking around curtains.
There's nothing like watching it live.
Oh, yeah. Bring it on. I got it. These guys can show you so many different moves, Brain, that you won't be able to track everything. Beautiful scoop slam. Rockers are indeed specialists in what they do inside that squared circle. And their eyes and guns set on one thing, the WWF Tag Team titles.
Oh, everybody's got their eyes set on that. Everybody wants that gold. And there's a lot of tough teams, I'll admit that.
Uh-huh.
But it's a lot more than muscle. You got to use brains.
All right, let's just take a hypothetical situation and say that the Brainbusters somehow or other defeated the Rockers. And their next challenge came from the Twin Towers. So long, Brainbusters.
No, I don't believe that. You see, the Brainbusters are an articulate team that not only have speed and agility, they know wrestling. They're a tag team. I would say they're specialists. But Akeem and the Big Boss Man, they've only been together a short time. They're both individuals.
But they've got the big edge, Brain.
They got
the slickster. Who are these guys got?
The Brainbusters got me.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Now, you're trying to twist things around. I don't need you to insult me.
No, you can take care of that all by yourself.
I beg your pardon. Leave this studio. Leave this booth right now. I'll wrap things up. I'll lock up.
Oh, look at that nice move.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. They're agile, and they know what they're doing in there. But what happens if we knock one of them out? Let's say we knock Jannetty out. Michaels has got to wrestle all by himself. He's not used to it. He's used to seeing...
What do you mean all by himself? It's tag team, buddy.
But I'm saying he's used to seeing his partner in the corner. We take one of these punks out early, it's over. The war is over. We've won the battle.
I think in a match between the Rockers and the Brainbusters, the most important asset in that match is going to be conditioning, and that has to go to the Rockers.
What do you think? The Brainbusters eat three or four peanut butter pies and a milkshake and take a nap?
Hey, I didn't say that. You did.
What a drop kick. We get an upset here.
Could be. Low. One pin out of there in a hurry.
Hey, this other team's impressing me. They're taking it to the Rockers.
Oh. Big mistake there. Could be the beginning of the end. Setting them up here. Irish whipping. Oh, nice mule kick right underneath the chin. Oh, he wasn't paying attention. You see what happens if you don't pay attention?
You gotta pay attention. You gotta use your brain. That's what I've been saying. Has the tag been made? I didn't see the tag.
Tag was made right there.
He went for it, but he didn't make it.
Goodbye. This one is over.
He did not make the tag.
What do you want to be, a referee now? Let's go to Mike Berger.
Big, powerful man.
Although you think about big and powerful, you have to be thinking about Big John Studd these days. Even you have to be impressed with Big John Studd at the Royal Rumble, Jess.
Slightly, McMahon, but again, at the Royal Rumble, so much relies on the luck of the draw.
Oh, yes,
if you're chosen first to survive the Royal Rumble, it would be unbelievable. If you're chosen last, you got a good chance.
Yep.
Look at the draw.
Columbia, South Carolina, John Ziegler.
Ziegler and what's that on his chest? He should go back to the shower.
Well, I'll tell you what, I don't envy these two guys getting in the ring with the powers of pain. And there you see Demolition. And what a showdown that's going to be when the powers of pain and Demolition get it on.
Oh, you see what happens when Ziegler runs into the Big Warlord. This man's massive. Huge.
And you know, quite agile and moves pretty good for a big man.
Sure does.
Look at him measuring him with those forearms.
How big were you, Jess, at your heaviest weight when you were wrestling?
The biggest I ever was 278.
278.
But I felt the best around 262 to 264.
You used to have those rippling abs, didn't you, like Rick Rude?
Yeah, I looked a lot like Rick Rude. Reminds me of me a lot. Massive calves, great abs.
Yep, that was you. Ziegler first.
And you know, to this day, McMahon, I didn't understand why I wore long tights with the calf development I had, but, you know, it was flashy.
Yeah, you were always one for the flash. Certainly not to conceal anything, Jess.
Well, I'll tell you what, Mr. Fuji sure is proud of this new tag team he's got. And what a maneuver he did. Can you imagine dumping the World Wrestling Federation champions for another team?
Yes,
remarkable.
Really,
I've never heard of such a thing.
Must really have high aspirations for this team, Mr. Fuji must have.
Well, you know, Fuji, he likes his tag teams to do what he says without questioning him. And apparently there was a problem where Demolition, feeling they were the champions, didn't have them to have to listen to Fuji anymore.
Reno Riggins looking at a clothesline, about a 300-some-odd-pound clothesline coming right at him, and it's over. These men are awesome.
The winners, the Powers of Pain.
Let's take you now to the World Wrestling Federation Event Center.
Welcome back to the Event Center. Friday evening, March 3rd. It happens at the Baltimore Arena. Folks, that date is not that far off. Start making plans to be there. The Birdman Coco, beware. He will be there. He will face Nikolai Volkov of the Russian Bolsheviks.
Coco, beware. Do you see a difference between me and you? You look at the 330 pounds of pure Russian muscle, and you have nothing but a 5-foot American pure fat. Will you come and live with me? I will do one thing and a second thing. First of all, I'll shoot you off and do it a simple, and then I will bury you down with a hammer, and you'll be gone once forever.
The size difference may exist, but when you consider what the Birdman Coco Beware is capable of, I would say this one is dead even. Mr. Perfect, he'll tangle with the mighty Hercules.
You know, I got up this morning and I went to the gym and I was moving around the intelligence, man. And the muscles started to pop out of my body. The blood started to flow in my veins. And I started to think about a certain name, a perfect individual, a Mr. Perfect. Now, where are you going to find somebody like that? He's got to be unique, and he's got to be Mr. Curt Hennig. Well, Curt Hennig, I'm sure you've already got it in your mind, already planned that you're going to leave me laying, a broken, defeated man. But there's no way, Curt Hennig, that you're going to beat me in that ring. Because I tell you what, I've been watching you. I've been studying you. I know a lot about you, man. And I'm going to find, and I'm going to show you your imperfections. Because you can't beat me, Curt Hennig.
The mighty Hercules, not impressed by anyone who believes they are perfect. And he is set to face Mr. Perfect Curt Hennig and find a few flaws. That happens Friday evening, March 3rd. Also that same evening, the Bushwhackers, Luke and Butch. They will face the fabulous Rougeau brothers, Jacques and Raymond. The mighty Hercules, he will face Mr. Perfect Curt Hennig, also Tito Santana. He will take on King Haku, king of the World Wrestling Federation. Also Bret the Hitman Hart. He will take on the Honky Tonk Man. And in a spectacular tag team encounter, Jake the Snake Roberts, the team of the Ultimate Warrior. They will face Ravishing Rick Rude and Andre the Giant, all part of a spectacular evening, Friday night, March 3rd, at the Baltimore Arena.
Competition, one of the fabulous Rougeau brothers, Jacques, who will meet one-on-one Brutus the Barber Beefcake. What a matchup that's going to be next week here on the Spotlight. But speaking of matchups, again, let's make reference, if we would, for the last time, what we're going to see this Friday night at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, Alfred, when the Mega Powers square off against the Twin Towers. What will be the outcome?
Vince, everybody is asking that. If I could tell you and would predict the truth, I would have to say maybe the Twin Towers. I say maybe because of this. The Mega Powers have come together now like they have never been together before. But it is professionally they've come together. Keep that in mind. Now think about...
In other words, there could be some truth to some possible personal friction.
There could be, but in any case, I don't expect either of these men to take any notice of that whatsoever for this occasion. Mm-hmm. Now look at their opposition. The Big Boss Man has already shown how he can deal with Hulk Hogan, and Akeem is a big, powerful man, 500 pounds, and he's already shown what he can do to Savage. Put those two talents together, and they may very well take out the combination of the mega powers.
Could very well. And, of course, the Doctor of Style will be in the corner of the Twin Towers, and the lovely Elizabeth will no doubt be right there in the corner of the mega powers. What a matchup this will be this coming Friday night at 8 p.m. Eastern.
Cheerio.